Finally, we turn to a NewsHour Shares, something that caught our eye that we thought might be of interest to you too. Summer is peak tourist season, and on popular islands like Nantucket and Martha's Vineyard, the locals roll out the welcome mat. But there is an island off the coast of New Hampshire where the inhabitants are downright hostile to visitors. From PBS station WGBH in Boston, Stephanie Lydon tells us why one woman keeps going back.
6 miles off the coast of Portsmouth, New Hampshire, White Island features stunning views, an historic lighthouse, and a cottage where Liz Craig's spending the summer.
We're right next to the lighthouse, and you'll probably hear the foghorn.
Sounds ideal, but
no running water.
You can pour water down the sink, but nothing's coming out of the pipes.
She hauls in water to drink, propane for the stove. This place is for the birds. Seabirds. They spend the summer here, too, on the island next door. At low tide, you can cross the rocks.
Watch out, because it's quite slippery.
And pay a visit. Just don't expect a warm welcome. There's a reason we're wearing these hats.
When the birds are truly aggressive, you'll see me, you know, out here, not just with this hat, but I'll put some padding in the base of it because they'll dive bomb and hit you as hard as they can in the head.
Their message? Don't mess with Mama Bird or Papa. They've come here to nest, an increasingly tricky proposition for this particular species called terns. This island is the only tern colony in New Hampshire, one of a dwindling number worldwide.
And now I'm going to measure the wing.
Which is why Liz Craig is here.
Of 179 millimeters.
She's a University of New Hampshire biologist, and along with technician Taylor Ouellette, is tracking the growth of the baby terns.
It's like a well baby visit with a pediatrician.
That's right. They get their checkup.
These checkups show many of the chicks are underweight, indicating they're not getting enough of the kind of food terns favor, herring and other small bait fish. It's a significant finding not only about the health of the birds, but also the ocean. If the terns are in trouble, local lobstermen who rely on the same fish could be too. Data collected from this colony is factored into local fisheries management.
You can see how the terns would be a great sort of indicator of what's going to happen next for the lobster industry.
Jennifer Seavey runs the Shoals Marine Laboratory and says, along with studying them, researchers are also seeking ways to better protect the terns, for whom survival has long been an uphill fight.
In the 1800s, they were part of the millinery trade. In fact, they put an entire tern on a hat.
And then there's the ever-present enemy, seagulls, which poach eggs and even adult terns. Just by being here, Liz Craig and her team discourage the gulls, safeguard another generation of terns, which will soon take flight for destinations as far as Argentina.
I say good luck, little baby.
The culmination of a season's labor for both humans and birds. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Stephanie Lydon on White Island, New Hampshire.